So now we are going to write a program to print the number of digits in a number. Okay, number of digits in a number. For example, if user has entered a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then the program will tell how many number of digits are there in this particular number. So the output in this case should be 5. Okay. So how can we do this using the programming? We can do this using the while loop. Okay. Let us take this same example and try to implement this theoretically. So we will take a variable count. Initially the count will be equal to 1. Okay, so count is initially 1. Then what we do? Suppose the user has entered the number in a variable 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, what we will do? We will divide n equal to n divided by 10. We will divide n by 10. So what we will get? We will get 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we have reduced the number by one digit, we have eliminated one digit, and then we will increment the count, count plus plus. Now the count becomes 2. Okay, and now we will repeat this thing again. N is equal to n divided by 10. Now n will become 1, 2, 3, and count plus plus, count will become 3. Because we have removed another digit. Okay, again we will do the same thing. N is equal to n divided by 10. Now n is 12 and count plus plus, count is now 2. Okay, n is equal to n divided by 10. Now n is 1. Sorry, the count here should be 4. Okay, initially the count was 1. After removal of one digit, count became 2. Next count became 3, count became 4, and now the count plus plus, the count now has become 5. Okay, now where should we stop? If we do n is equal to n divided by 10, the answer will be 0. Okay, so we should stop here. We should stop here. So we should put a condition that when the number of digits become 1, the loop should stop. So how can we put such a condition? How can we put all this manual programming into a C++ programming code? For that, let us declare here int count and initialize it to 1, and here also we have number n, and the value of n will be entered by the user. Now we can start the while loop, and in the while loop what condition should be put? The condition should be n divided by 10 is not equal to 0, right? We are stopping when n divided by 10 is 0. Okay, so n divided by 10 should not be equal to 0. When this condition is true, this loop will continue. When this condition becomes false, the loop will stop. Okay, and inside the body of the loop, what are we doing? We are dividing n by 10, n is equal to n divided by 10, and we are incrementing the count, count plus plus. Okay, and at the end we can print the count, cout count. It will tell us the number of variables in the count. Okay, now we are going to code this program to find the number of digits in a given number entered by the user. Okay. As you know, we need a number n. This number will store the value entered by the user. So we will print a prompt on the screen, enter a number. Okay. Then scene n. The user will enter the number. We need a special variable count to count the number of digits. Initially, the value of count will be 1. Now we can start the while loop. In the while loop, the condition will be n divided by 10 is not equal to 0. Okay. And here, what we will do? N is equal to n divided by 10 and count plus plus. Okay. Lastly, we need a return statement. Return 0. Okay. Now run it. Let us save it. Okay. There is error. IO stream. Okay. Build it again. Enter a number. Now I will enter the same number which we used as an example. Oh, it is not giving us any output because we forgot to print the output. Okay, so here we will print the output. See out the number of digits in n is count. Okay. Let's run it again. Okay, the number of digits in 1 is 5. It is although it is giving us the correct output, the number of digits are 5, but it is not printing the original number correctly. There must be some problem. The number of digits in n is, it is correct. Okay, we will try to run it again. Let's enter another number. 7254, something like this. Okay, the number of digits in this number is 6. Okay, so let us count the number of digits. These are 6. Originally the count will be 1. After removing the last digit, it becomes 2, then 3, 4, 5, then 6. And at the last, we are left with 7. When 7 is divided by 10, 7 divided by 10, the output will be 0. So here the condition will become false and the loop will stop. Okay. So in this way, this program is able to give us the number of digits. And another thing to note in this program is that we are using a while loop in this program, not a for loop. Can we use a for loop in this program? No, we cannot use the for loop. Why? Because for loop is a predefined loop. It means we predefine, we define in advance the number of times the loop will be iterated. But in case of this program, where the user enters the number can be 3-digit long, 4-digit long, 5-digit long, 6-digit long. So number can be of any length. So it is not decided in advance that how many times this loop will run. Okay, so this loop runs as long as the condition is true. Okay, so as long as this condition is true, this loop runs. Okay, so this is the difference between the for loop and the while loop.